For me, I think family is what keeps it all together. And it's what, at the end of the day, makes it all worth it. You know, knowing that you are representing your family well, be it in the uniform or in the uniform that he wears. I think that without our families, it's really hard to really and truly sometimes go the extra mile.
Family's very important to me. Throughout the trials and tribulations I've been through, without family, I wouldn't be in the position I am. And without family, you won't learn a lot of the life lessons.
So what's one thing that you really appreciate about Ricky, about him as a brother, as a sibling?
Is that he listens.
Ah, oh, that's a good one.
Yeah, that he listens. That he listens and that I think that he actually values my opinion and he values my thoughts, and that's important.
It's like the other day I called her about something and I asked her for advice and she told me. So me being a little brother, you already know you're going to tiptoe around it just to see, just to be that brother, and what she said was going to happen, it did. And it's like, she got my trust. Like, she told me the truth. Like, she didn't tell me a lie. She said this was going to happen, and it did. And when her just doing that just built my trust. It built me like, that's my big sister.
I call him Warrior.
Warrior?
Yeah, it's just kind of like the same way that, you know, we're warriors. I mean, every time he goes out on the field, it's a game, yeah, but he's playing to win, just like we, when we go out in the field, we're playing to win. You know, yeah, our equipment is a little bit different, but nevertheless, I think our instinct is the same. We have come to win. You know, we want that W, you know, so I call him Warrior. Like, go out there and get him, Warrior. For us to continue to be the warriors that are needed to face whatever enemy out there, we have to care about here, and we have to make sure that this is as strong as any other part of our body, you know. So to me, mental health is what makes us tough.
When we're at the age when we first start playing football, I mean playing professional football, age 22 23, we're not caring about mental health. We're just caring about the fame, the fortune, the money. So I just tell them, like, man, just sit down and just, and let's talk about it, no matter how we got to talk about it. And at the end of the day, hey, try this out. Or when you get home, try this out. Or try to read a book. My biggest thing is I ask dudes, what's the last book you read? Please don't tell me a playbook, because if you tell me a playbook, I'm going to throw it at you. I want you to actually tell me the last book to read. So I start recommending books to them. And then it starts showing that they start opening up. Then it starts, you just start using the exercise inside the book. People just don't understand, like, mental health is the most important thing, because the one thing that controls your body is your mind. If you know how to control your mind, the rest of your body will follow.
We have to be okay with getting help. We have to be okay with trusting our family that they're steering us in the right direction, and that our family loves us and cares about us, that when they're giving us guidance and giving us direction on how to deal with ourselves and how to deal with the things that we face, I think that's important, you know, just accepting the help.
Be there for yourself.
Be there for each other.
Be there, Marine.